Hello YouTube viewers, welcome to my show Computer Wednesday. Today we're gonna take a look into networking, home versus office networking. As you can remember, in last episode we looked at internet, so now let's dive into networking. So let's look at the few reasons why do we need it. You have to understand there are many benefits and side effects also. So primary benefit is it's more fast and stable, and if you have only one point of internet in your home, as in like you are getting your connection from optical fiber or cable network or any such things where you have only one point of incoming, you need networking for allowing to multiple devices. Otherwise, like you have to like, you know, disable one device then connect to another device, suffice to say, is gonna be very tedious. For that reason we do networking, and sometimes we also have what's called extra hardware, like on network, like a printer, because nowadays many printers support network printing. You can't directly connect internet to them, like it's gonna be very clumsy, so we do networking for solving this sort of issues. So let's dive into what are the components of it. So you have to understand, first is ISP, which we call internet service provider. So they are like ACT, BSNL, Jio, all those things like that. And then we come to modem. Your internet service provider and modem is interlocked. So let's say, for instance, ACT provides using fiber. You're not gonna buy a fiber to normal Ethernet modem, because, well, they might be using different spectrum, different cable types, different anything. So ISP and modem is interlocked. Same goes for, like, let's say, for instance, you are using something like a cable network. Cable to Ethernet is also, again, uncommon. You may buy them if they are very popular, but for this reason we generally link these two, ISP and modem, as a same unit, because you don't have much control over it. After that we come to router is generally responsible for communicating your internal network, as in everything that is inside your home, to the outer network, which is World Wide Web, basically the entire internet. So it needs a one gateway, so to say. So your gateway is generally called as router. Now after that we come to switch. If you have multiple devices, of course, once you have the gateway, you need a path or like lanes or roads to all the components. So we employ what's called switches. Switches generally are kind of smart hubs, where they know which computer is at which port, and they're gonna, you know, forward information inside. And then we come to last, this is very recently added nowadays, it's called access point, where you may see things like that in your, you know, in your roof in office and things like that. They are generally for Wi-Fi extension. So from switches to the Wi-Fi, it goes like that. So these are the primary components of your networking. So let's dive into it. So when we come to home networking, you have to realize all those things that I mentioned, you might be able to buy one device like this and that's it. Or heck, you can have a battery powered thing that does all of it. So why is that such importance? For home users, you have to understand convenience plays a very important role. Everything has to work. Like you don't want to deal with hassles of wire. You want to be like quick, agile, simple, as simple as that. And it has very few users. Like how many people are gonna use your network at the time, like as in your home at the same moment. Like let's say you work at night, or somebody only comes uses your network in the morning, or things like that. There are very few scenarios where you'll have like 5-6 people working at your network at full speed all the time. And it has very low data transfer. Like you're not gonna have, even if you have, let's say, 100 megabytes per second connection, it's not very likely that you're gonna, you know, use that 100 megabyte per second all the time. Like I had that connection, but only time I can use it is when I'm watching 4K content, which was very very short amount of time. So it has very low data transfer. So that's why everything I mentioned in the last slide, they are all combined into one unit. So that's for convenience. So now we know about home, let's look at businesses. So businesses have obviously lot of users. So you have to be understanding, like they might not have 2-3 people, they might have 20, 30 or 500-600 people. So in that time, they have to make sure their network infrastructure can handle this amount of traffic, so to say. And they cannot afford the luxury of, like, you know, your network being down, because it's not going to affect one or two people, it's going to affect the entire company. That's why they need to have very low downtimes. And it's very large, like, it expands to very large. And you might say, okay, let's say there are 500 computers, 500 employees, you might have 50 printers, 20-30 security cameras, heck, even more security cameras than that, and a lot of other things that are also communicating through the same network backbone. So you have to be very mindful. Like, networks, you might just don't simply think of them like, okay, this many computer, that's it. No, there are many things that are gonna pile up, so it becomes very large very quickly. And it has to be safe and reliable. Like, reliability is very crucial. You can't have your company go down because some modem failed or things like that happened. And safety, many of these companies deal with what's called intellectual property. If they lose that, they're gonna go bankrupt, basically. So, like, you cannot have a movie studio working in a scenario where somebody just accidentally hacked it and now I've seen the movie before it was even released. So safety is very crucial, and almost all large businesses, even small businesses, have what's called network attached storage or things like that. So what it is, it's like a central repository where everybody can access it. It's just it's on the network rather than in some PC. So the benefit is, let's say you created a document that you want to make sure that everybody sees, you put it in the network. So network itself does not have any storage. That's why we use this. And let's say you shut down your computer, no problem. The everybody coming after you and, like, they want to look at that file, they can call the data from that. So these are the core aspects of business network. So as you can see, they invest a lot of money in this. So what is my point in this? Know yourself very basically. Like, if you are in a scenario where you have multiple devices, let's say multiple smart TV, you have a multiple printer, not likely, but you could have two printers where, you know, one is inkjet, one is laser printer. In that sort of scenario, it's wise to use LAN cables. It's very, it's not recommended to use Wi-Fi for everything, simply because Wi-Fi A is not secure, B it's range limited, C is very susceptible to interference. Let's say somebody turned on a microwave, sometimes your Wi-Fi network may fall, or other things could happen randomly outside of your control. That's why if you want to make sure your things are connected and working all the time, you want to use your Ethernet cable. And things like television, printers, these things you're not gonna move, so please use that. And dedicated hardware has its own use. So as in my first slide I mentioned, like, there is a router. A router is the gateway. So what you buy nowadays, like, you know, that D-Link or whatever you want to buy, it has everything. But a corporation or even a smart individual who takes their internet security seriously, they will build their own router, especially if you have, like, multiple people using it. What's the point? Since that is the gateway, if you have security there, not at your computer but at the gateway itself, it's suffice to say, you can, like, you can have firewall there, you can have antivirus there, you can have data logging there itself, in which case you can directly detect, hey, let's say somebody, you know, put their computer to sleep and somehow data is still going because, let's say, there is a malware router that is powerful enough that can detect it. Now you can use your old computer as a router. So router is the gateway, like, that is very crucial. And you have to understand, like, let's say you had bought a modern router which has all-in-one sort of system, and let's say you decided you bought a phone, mobile phone, which used 5 gigahertz Wi-Fi, which is faster, has low range but it's faster, ASP. Instead of buying a whole new router, you might decide, hey, I'm just gonna buy an access point which you can communicate through the your old router. You don't need to buy a whole new thing, and you can place it where it's more convenient. So that's why, like, please spend time in networking. It's not it's unwise to be like, you know, have one thing in your basement and, like, hey, I don't get very strong Wi-Fi signal. That's why people use access point. It's like, so they can spread it out where they actually need it. And Ethernet connection, let's say you are watching your 4K Netflix, here's the deal, even 5 gigahertz Wi-Fi barely can support 20 to 25 gigabytes per megabytes per second. Your stream may exceed it, and generally your Netflix wants to stream ahead, so it has some buffer. That's fine. Use LAN as much as you can. It's still the best option we have. So I hope you guys liked it, learned from it. In that case, please like. If you didn't, please dislike, leave a comment and subscribe. I upload video every day. Thanks for watching.